a lot of Jewish people also in the area, and they, you know how the Jewish people on their Sabbath, they're not allowed to do anything?
Right.
Did you know that, Peter?
No.
Yeah, they can't use electricity.
Yeah, you can't do any work.
You can't drive.
Yeah, so they would approach these women, like my mother and her friends and relatives, and they'd ask, if you do this for us, we'll either, I don't think they were paid in money, I think they were given food or, you know, something like that. So they were able to survive to some extent like that. And they just walked all this time. And it was 5 years. It was from 1915 until 1920.
Wow.
And where do you think they were? In Aleppo. You're familiar with that, right?
Yeah. That's where she ended up.
That's where she ended up. And in the meantime, believe it or not.
So they wandered the desert for 5 years.
Yeah. My father, now the war has ended, he doesn't come over because I think these men are they're afraid. They don't believe that if they come over that
they'll be allowed to live.
Yeah, or, you know, they'll get back into this country. Mm. But he got in touch with, I'll call it somebody in the English army, or they were the English anyway. And, you know, he told them that my wife has been here for 5 years and I'm trying to locate her, et cetera, et cetera. And they said, okay, give us all the information that you have and we'll see what we can do. And would you believe they located her?
That's amazing.
Yes.
So your father was here?
No. Yes.
He was here. He contacted somebody from England?
Yeah.
And the English found your mother.
And the English found grandma.
And
was she still in Aleppo at that point?
Yeah. And then she left Aleppo. I think she also stopped in Greece. But these are just, you know, they're just moving. And then she went to France, Marseille, France. And once she got to Marseille, France, she crossed France to go to Le Havre, which is one of the
cities,
but it's a seaport city. Mm. And, you know, they don't have any money. Don't ask me how they did things. But she got on a ship and she came to this country. But in the meantime, because of all this traveling in, you know, in the desert, her eyes are a mess.
Aww.
She really doesn't see well.
From the heat and the sand?
And all the things
that happened, I mean.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so, at this time, your father probably doesn't know he's lost his son, either.
Well, I'm sure.
Probably assumed.
Well, I think that, now, believe it or not, my mother could not read or write, not even Armenian. So, anything that she wanted my father to know,
she'd have to tell somebody.
Yeah, there's somebody around that could write. So, I think he knew what had taken place. And I think that's one of the reasons why he's afraid to even leave this country.
Sure.
So now, my mother has reached Ellis Island, and she knows that her eyes are bad, and she's afraid that when the Americans find out that she's coming in with diseased eyes, they're going to send her back.
Aww.
So, the way she tells it, she's in line. There's a line of them. And they all, you know, talk to the Americans that are taking care of getting them through. And there's somebody in front of her that's causing all kinds of trouble. And then you wonder where I got mine. My mother says, and of course she can only speak Armenian, right. But there's translators, so they understand. So she's saying to this person that's in line ahead of her, knock it off. I want to, you know, go and get, you know, to where my husband is.
Right.
I haven't seen him.
I'm waiting forever for this, and you're going to cause a stink right now?
Yeah. You know, I haven't seen him in 5 years, and look at what you're doing. You're delaying me. And the American, who also can understand Armenian, hears all this. So he tells her, oh, okay, I mean, if you weren't A-okay, you wouldn't be causing this kind of a rumpus. So go, you know,
we're not going to ask you 20 questions.
You're done. Yeah. And they're yelling at, I guess it was a man that was ahead of her, and, you know, they're doing whatever they had to do. But she says,
I couldn't
believe it, she says, that there I am causing problems.
Well, but it was a gift. It saved her from probably a little persecution.
Well, so she said that she was able to. But I remember, I don't go to school yet, but I remember going to the Worcester City Hospital in Worcester with Grandma so that she could get her eyes
worked on.
Yeah, treated, and finally.
Didn't you say that they scraped the surface of them?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that one from when I was a little kid. They couldn't operate on cataracts and stuff.
Right.
So I guess they scraped away the outer layer or something. I don't know.
It wasn't cataracts, Pete. It was trachoma or something like that. Not glaucoma. It was glaucoma, trachoma.
I don't know.
And all this other
stuff. So they were able to give her a vision.
They were. She was able to get her vision back. Yeah. Wow. Good. Wow.
And then my poor mother. Now she's got, I don't know, I have it on a family tree. I don't know how many pregnancies she went through, but some of them were stillbirths, etc. Mm-hmm. But four of us were born to her.
After your brother.
Yeah.
After the brother in Armenia.
Yeah.
That's,
and she's the youngest, so.
So.
Is Auntie Annie the oldest, or was Uncle George the oldest?
Oh, Uncle George was the oldest.
Mm. So how old would he be now, if Auntie Annie's 92?
He would have been 94. Hmm. There was 2 years in between Anne and George and Paul.
Right.
And then, as I would always say to my mother, and then I was 3 years. A troublemaker.
Yeah.
But, let's see. 4 years difference between Uncle Paul and I.
Okay.
So, anyway.
So that's the story. How my grandmother got here.
That's amazing.
Yeah, and I mean, look at Uncle Abe. I don't know if you even know this, Peter, that he escaped from the Turks because, you know.
So they were coming after him to take him.
Well, he was already taken.
Yeah.
He's in the Turkish army.
Oh.
You know, he's not about to fight for the Turks, and he manages to escape, finds the French, and he was in the French Foreign Legion. I've got pictures of him.
Really?
Yeah. And
Abe and your father were brothers, right?
Yes.
That's Abe here.
On the left is Abe, on the right is my grandfather.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So they were brothers.
Yeah.
And
handsome.
And then the one thing I wanted to mention,
I think,
to you that I forgot to. Now, when my mother is in France and they're getting papers ready so that she can get on board a ship and get to this country, and they have a lot of information and a lot of descriptions, and you can't tell from this picture of my mother, but there she is. What do you think they gave as her hair color?
Oh, no. Black? This is your mom?
Yeah. On her paper, we have it in writing, right, Peter? Mm-hmm. She's blonde.
What?
Yeah.
She's not blonde.
Well, that's the color that they gave her.
These are your parents.
Yeah,
that's your aunt and uncle?
Yeah.
They're all so attractive.
Well, they...
Where do you think I get her from?
Say that again?
I said, where do you think I get her from?
Yeah.
Humble, too.